Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. In today's video guys, we're working here on a Porsche Cayenne third generation 2003 to 2010, and we'll show you guys how to remove and replace radiator fan. We have more than 200 videos on this car, so please subscribe for more videos, and if you need help with anything, drop a comment below. We'll try to make a video for you. So this is the 4.5 V8, but I think the 6-cylinder will be the same. Always double check that. But I believe the procedure for removing the radiator fan will be about the same, except for the intake. The intake part might differ, so skip that part if you have the 6-cylinder, and you can see how the fan attaches to the radiator and how to remove it now. So let's start on it. So all the tools and parts that we use in this video guys will be listed in the description of the video below. So check it out if you need help with anything. So now we need a Torx 30 bit. Okay, this is a Torx 30 bit. And let me explain how you remove, okay, those plastic bolts here and the one on the, also on the air box right there. Now most people will break those, and I'll show you how. And you will not even suspect that yours were broken probably. So as you can see, okay, on top of this bolt right here, okay, there is one dot. Okay, this dot right here. So this dot, guys, okay, needs to face this way in order to be able to pull it out. Usually, when they're locked in place, it will be placed like that, opposite. Then you have to turn it this way, okay, to, okay, you can see that white thing of the plastic, the where it's a little bit wider than the rest of it, that's where it needs to face. The same will apply to this one here. Okay, and for this one, the easiest thing will be to actually, okay, disconnect the throttle body cable here. Okay, so it's not in the way. I'll leave it like that. And you can see it's already where it's supposed to be. When it's locked, it's like that. And now we need to bring that dot here to the white part and see what will happen. Now stay with us to show you about the airbox, because that's a very tricky situation too. Now there is one tooth on the bottom side that goes in that white opening. Now that tooth will break if people are not careful, so you need to make sure everything aligns. And after that, all you have to do, okay, grab it, okay, with the pliers and just pull it straight out without twisting. Okay, our tooth is broken. That's where it was supposed to be. It's not there anymore because somebody messed it up. Now, the same thing with you to this side here. Okay. This one got stuck a little bit, so let me make sure that it's situated where it's supposed to be. Okay, I see that thing actually on the bottom, that tooth, that it's bent. So somebody tried to pull it out the wrong way, and now that's going to cost us a little bit, because it will be stuck. So in our case, I'll have to move it a little bit left or right until it goes in the canal, okay? And it came out. Okay, you can see this tooth, half of it is still good, half is not. So you need to make sure that this little bitty tooth, okay, right here guys, check it out, this little bitty thing goes in this canal right here. You can see how we have the two canals, otherwise you'll not be able to pull it out. Now the same thing to the air box right here, but a little bit different location. Now you can see when they're locked in place, that's how they face forward. Now we need to bring that dot, okay, here, to match this dot on the back side, okay, over here. So we'll just turn it, okay, like that, and the same thing to this one here. Perfect. Now let me see if I can pull those guys out now. Okay, check out the tooth on the bottom, this one is still good. And one more on this side. Okay, need to situate it exactly where it needs to go. If it doesn't come out, okay, don't break it. You need to move it a little bit. Something's not aligning. Okay, so eventually, okay, it comes out. Okay, this is this one here as well. Now, need to go to this side now. Okay, and we need to do the same thing. Now you can see the dots are on the back side. Okay, right here. So I'll turn them to align this with the dot there. And this with that dot. Okay, we'll need to go ahead and pull them out now. Okay, this one came out easy. One of them always tend to get stuck for some reason. Okay, so this one came out too. You can check it out here now. How you disconnect the mass airflow sensors? Okay, now right here, that connector. First step will be push it in. Okay, you need to push it in so you release the pressure right here on that tube. And after that, while you're pushing in, push that tube back and pull it out, guys. You can see the tube is inside, right here. Same thing to this side, but the tube is on the bottom, so you cannot see it so good. Okay, but that's what we do. And now, okay, we have one vacuum hose underneath that we need to disconnect here. You just squish, okay, let me explain it here quick. Come to show you with the camera. On that vacuum hose right here, you need to squish those two things in and pull it out. Okay, just like that. So what we'll need to do now, we'll need to disconnect the cable. Okay, that's the main cable that comes to the fan. Okay, if that thing is stuck, what do you need to do? Press the two pieces together, okay, like that. Keep pressing, and there is one tooth right here that you need to push back. Okay. And okay, you can see ours is about to come out. Okay, let me just pull it out of the holder here so I can show you. Okay, that tooth right here. Okay, perfect. And this is the fan. Now we need to get a clip removal tool and we need to disconnect, okay, here, or we can unsnap it like that. Okay, and get the cables out. Now this is one of the cables. Now we need to disconnect the second one. Okay, this one, the same thing. Push in, release the clip, pull out. Okay, it's coming out, but it's very, okay, very limited room, by the way. And I'm going to help the clip a little bit here with the screwdriver. And let me get a clip removal tool quick. All the parts and tools that we use, guys, will be in the video below. And we're going to disconnect that clip. Okay, I'll need probably to get a flat one. Okay, right here. And this one is so tight. So you have to be careful not to break your fan as well. Okay, now we should be able, okay, to pull it out, okay, hopefully. Okay, perfect, this is the second cable out of the way. Okay, now with a big flathead screwdriver, okay, right here underneath, guys. I will not be able to show you on this side, I'll show you on the next one. There is a clip that you need to push in, And at the same time, grab the fan and pull it up. Okay, I couldn't do it here. Okay. Let me see now. Okay, I need to come on this side now. Okay, check out where that clip now is. Okay, this clip right here. Okay, this clip will need to go in. And at the same time, you need to pull the fan out. Okay, so this one right here, okay, we're going to push it down, push it in, and pull up. Okay, now, let me see on this side what else is holding here. Okay, it went in on this side, so we need to pull it up again. Okay, perfect. Now, we need to gently start, okay, pulling the thing up. Okay, so I'm holding a little bit on the bottom on the right side now. You have to be careful not to break anything in the way. Almost coming out like one of the seals got stuck here. Okay, and it came out, guys. You can see, okay, just like that. So you can see, guys, the fan came out of the car just like that. Not very complicated, it takes some time. You have to be very gentle, especially right here. Okay, you can see you have on this side you have the transmission lines, I believe. On this one you have coolant, actually the Freon pipes right there, and here is the transmission. That's where the things that we were pressing with the screwdriver are. Okay, one here and one on this side. Then on the bottom side, okay, you have two glides, one here and one on the other side down there. And on the very bottom, okay, when you install the fan, you have two holes where it's supposed to go in, so make sure you get those correct as well. So that's how we guys removed it. Installations in reverse order. Hopefully the video will be helpful to some of you. Please hit that subscribe button for all the work we do, and see you guys next time.